John said. More on that coming up this morning.
It's 16 minutes past six, and they are the people responsible for defending our skies and securing the seas. But much of the work that's done by the Royal Air Force goes on behind closed doors.
Well, now, a six-part documentary aims to show what life is really like for the pilots and personnel who are working to protect the nation. Let's take a look.
Yeah, Robert. What's it down in Zoe?
The enemy as you could be.
There's no task, interrogation.
Looking out the window, we can see these two straight lines of cloud coming our way. You don't know what's going on, but there's something there.
Echo India 02, eyeball.
Now I'm looking at it, trying to figure out what it is.
227. To bogey number two break.
Oh my god, that's a Russian fighter. Here they come.
That documentary, it's called Top Guns Inside the RAF. It's on Channel 4 tonight at 9 o'clock.
And our reporter Zoe O'Brien has special access at RAF Lossiemouth. And Zoe, so what is going on this morning? All quiet, it looks like, so far.
Yes, well, good morning. It is a quiet morning to start off with at RAF Lossiemouth. And I've got to say, it is picture perfect here. But as you just saw there, this base, the UK's busiest operational airbase, plays a pivotal role in our defences. Now, it's just waking up this morning, everyone just coming to life, although there are pilots stationed here ready 24/7 to scramble. What you can see behind me here, these are maritime patrol aircraft, also known as sub hunters. And I'm lucky enough to be joined by two of the people who operate them. So I'm going to come over and talk to Roxy first. Now, Roxy, in the documentary, we can see you in your role as a pilot and a trainer. How difficult is it to get airborne, to get that training and get up there?
Well, by the time the individuals arrive at Lossiemouth, they've gone through a number of training courses. They've been selected to fly the Poseidon, and we take them and we train them as individuals. So the pilots are taught how to initially fly the airplane. We'll take them and go to places like Newcastle or Prestwick to do circuits, practice the landings, fly instrument approaches, whilst the individuals who operate the kit down the back are taught how to do that in isolation. And then following that, as you'll see in the documentary, we put them all together and we teach them to operate as a crew to prepare them to fly operations in the UK waters or abroad in support of UK military intent.
Now, for people who don't know, what is a sub hunter? What do the sub hunters do?
So the Poseidon that you see behind us, a maritime patrol aeroplane, our job is to support the UK's intelligence and surveillance plan to provide an overall picture of what's happening in our area of responsibility, which stretches from here all the way towards halfway towards the United States. So we've got a massive area, and our job is to make sure that we know the position of everything and anything that's operating in the air, on the surface or below the surface.
Now, as we've been saying already this morning, ready to scramble at a moment's notice, 24/7, 365 days a year. What is it like living here on this base, people working here on this base?
Well, we're not quite at a moment's notice. It takes us a little bit of time to wind that aeroplane, but it's great. Lossiemouth is a fantastic place to work and live. As you can see, the weather is always like this. Rarely rains here, and very little of the poor weather that you might see in other places. It's a great place to live. The aeroplane is a fantastic bit of kit. It puts us world-leading individuals responsible for our job. This is what we do, and we do it well.
And with everything going on in the world at the moment, how busy are you?
We're very busy. We're quiet today, as you pointed out at the start, but that's because we've just come back from an intense period of 24/7 operations. We were keeping the residents of Lossie awake for the last week, launching an airplane every 4 hours to update our maritime picture.
I'm sure they don't mind. Roxy, thank you very much. I'm going to come over here and talk to Alex. Now, Alex, you also feature in the documentary, in the Sub Hunters. You've just come off your training. Tell me, what is it like, that training course? Is it hard?
Yeah, the training course is hard, but everything that is rewarding is hard. Some of the pilots probably need a bit more training, but no, it was a good course and very enjoyable.
And we talk a lot about the pilots. What we sometimes don't talk about are the hundreds of other people who, you know, who keep us safe. What are you doing when you're up there in the Sub Hunter?
So I'm an electronics warfare operator. We call the pilots the bus drivers. They put the jet where we need it, and then we go to work and we utilise the sensors to maximise our probability to detect on enemy submarines and surface vessels.
When we talk about, you know, what you're doing up there, sub hunting, to me that just sounds like, you know, a really, really difficult job to, you know, to do what you're doing. How hard is it?
Some people say it's harder than others. It depends on the target. It depends where it is. Sometimes it can be very straightforward, sometimes quite complicated.
And RAF Lossiemouth is huge here. It's a site over 2 square miles, more than 3,000 personnel. What's it like being here, you know, because it's quite remote up here. It's far north in Lossiemouth.
It is very far north, but you've got great connections to get. Well, I'm from the south coast, so I can just go to Inverness Airport and fly home, be home within an hour and a half, so it's not that bad. And, you know, you can see the sunrise this morning. It's gorgeous.
What would you say to anybody? What's your advice if someone wants to join the Royal Air Force?
Just get down to your local careers office, have the conversation, and get after it.
Job of your dreams?
Possibly. Yeah, no, it's a great job. It is a great job.
Fantastic. Well, thank you very much. Now, if you are interested, if you want to know more, if you want to see more, that documentary, Top Guns, Inside the RAF, that begins tonight on Channel 4.
Zoe, thank you very much indeed. Great to see the behind the scenes at RAF Lossiemouth this morning. I think we're going to have a live takeoff, aren't we, in about an hour's time?
Let's hope so.
Yes, we are. We are.
No, an hour and a half, I think.
Okay.
People who are going to stay and watch for that. It will be spectacular.
It will. It's 23 minutes past six, and we're going to talk now about something which we know that so many of you are maddened by.